everyone, Uncle Jessy here. A few weeks ago, I showed you how you could use a resin 3D printer to make your own action figures. And they actually articulate. And in this case, I'm using the files from TeccoToys. But one of the issues that I ran into is that some of the joint areas get a little bit chalky after you've used them for just a little bit. And this is because of the cured resin rubbing up against each other. And today we're gonna be looking at a new resin from the folks over at Siraya Tech. This is called Mecha Resin. And we're gonna reattempt to print these resin 3D printed action figures because this resin is supposed to be a lot more durable when it comes to resin rubbing up against itself, which should honestly be perfect for this application. And with any new resin, I like to run some calibration prints to make sure that I have the resin properly dialed in before we print anything of substance. So I like to run these calibration prints from Denny's Wang and Siraya Tech. Unfortunately, I was running into some issues dialing in the exposure initially. Thankfully, the Elgu Mars 3 has a tank clean feature that makes the cleanup process a lot easier. After re-leveling the build plate and running a few more exposure tests, I was able to find an exposure of 2.5 and a bottom exposure of 30 that worked best for me. I did also run into some odd issues where some of the resin partially fused with the Wham Bam flex plate and was a bit of a pain to remove. I then started printing a handful of the TeccoToys files at the default scale for us to take a look at. Once I removed them from the build plate, I cleaned them in IPA on the Elgu wash and cure unit for about 2 minutes and then let them air dry. I also noticed that this Mecha resin was a little bit stronger with its fumes, so I ran some prints with the Elgu Saturn S that has a built-in air filtration unit, and I used the rechargeable ones that I have for the Elgu Mars 3. And overall, initially the prints look fantastic coming off the printers. So initially I printed a whole bunch of the miniature space marines from TeccoToys along with their new armor system there that goes on top of those marines. However, the big problem comes in when it actually comes to assembling the figures. So I've tried two different methods for this, like I did previously in my last video, where I went off and cleaned the pieces, let them dry, and then cured, then tried assembling, and the parts just do not want to fit, or I can get them to fit and the resin's just too brittle and the parts break. So I then tried the alternative, which was to clean the prints, then let them dry and assemble before curing. This seems to work a good bit better. However, it's just not holding the parts together as well as I was hoping it would. There just seems to be a lot of expansion with this resin compared to the typical resins that you might work with. And it's just making it very hard to either keep the parts assembled or just to get them assembled together. Also, in hindsight, I probably should have tested out just some of the joints before running off and printing so many of these figures. That was a major mistake on my end. And in the original video, I printed TeccoToys files at the default scale, along with printing them larger at 200% scale, and they were just too loose in the joints. Everything went together very nicely here, but nothing really held in place. All of the joints were super loose. So that got me thinking, maybe I should try reprinting some of the figures at 200% scale, and that's where we're at right now. So I printed all of the mech parts on the Elgu Saturn S, and then I printed all of the actual person files there, again at 200% scale on the Elgu Mars 3. And why this looks a shade pink or purple is because I wanted to see what kind of impact it might have if you have a little bit of alcohol ink into the mix here. Also, it just helps things pop a little bit more on camera because recording white, it's probably very hard to see the details on these figures. Also, because the TeccoToys articulation points were very small and fragile, I went off and found these a free action figure that you can download off of Prusa Printers from Souza. It's called Lucky 13. So I printed these, the actual articulation body parts in the Siraya Tech resin here and the Mecha resin. And then I just used the standard Elgu ABS-like resin for the skin parts or the outside armor for the little robot figure person. So hopefully out of these two print jobs, we'll end up with something that we can actually test out and see how well it works with this resin. So I don't know why I didn't think about this before, but for any of those parts that are difficult to actually assemble together, I just got a cup of really hot water. And if we sit some of the prints in there, like here is one of the smaller figurines that I was able to get assembled and it's working really well here. It's still pretty fragile, so you've got to be very careful with it. But I can put these shoulder and arm joints here in the hot water and let it sit for like, I don't know, 30 seconds, and it's really hot water in this little cup that I'm not gonna reuse again, just gonna be using it now for heating up some of these prints. And after we get it out, we can very carefully pop these into place. And with these 200% scale figurines, there's just no way that the parts are gonna go together cleanly here without potentially breaking anything. That goes in so much easier after they've warmed up. And yes, I know this is like an old trick that lots of people have used for years and years and years with actual action figures when it comes to modding them, but it works really well here with the resin printed pieces as well. So very happy to see that. By the way, again, the I can't believe how that just popped right into place. No effort whatsoever needed. One other really crazy thing about this particular resin is that it feels almost like it's injected molded plastic. It doesn't feel like other resin once it's printed. I'm not quite sure exactly how to describe it exactly, but it just feels like plastic, something that you would have actually gotten out of a molded piece of a plastic versus something that you've printed in resin. Typically resin has like a little bit of a filminess to it. This just feels like hard plastic. It's crazy. Well, I tried. I really gave it my best go here with this figure from TeccoToys. The file itself is amazing. All the parts printed beautifully here on the Elgu Saturn and the Elgu Mars 3. Unfortunately, the resin is just too brittle for this application. I'm really hoping that Siraya Tech comes out with another variation of this resin that has a little bit more durability or flexibility baked into it, because the actual articulation areas where I was able to get it together and the joints held in place, when you do move them, there is no chalkiness whatsoever, which is, you know, again, that was the intended purpose of this, is that it wasn't going to wear. So it was more for mechanical purposes than this here. And I think they've got some use cases where people are using those as motors or components within motors, and people have posted about that and how well it's worked for them. Unfortunately, for this particular application, just so far, it's not going very well. I should also point out that the white resin, I cured it for 2 minutes under the UV light. No yellowing whatsoever, as far as I can tell. And it's, again, just, it feels like it's injected molded plastic. This feels like a legit toy that I'm holding in my hands versus something that I've went off and 3D printed. Now, they don't recommend it, but I am gonna try and mix in a little bit of Tenacious with the Mecha white resin here. I have just enough here that I believe that I should be able to print off another set of those armor pieces for the mech figure. So let's give it a go. All right, the prints have finished curing, and again, these are mixed with the Tenacious, which should add a little bit more flexibility to the prints. Now, I'm still gonna go with the approach because I think it's still not gonna be... No, I'm gonna heat these up still. I don't wanna break them. So I've got my bottle of hot water here. I'm gonna set the prints in it and let it sit for about 30 seconds to a minute. All right, let's give this a test and see. Oh! That went in so much better. The last time I tried to do this with the non-Tenacious mixed part, it immediately broke here on the little joining clasp piece. That worked perfect. I'm gonna go through the process of now reprinting all the armor files because, again, I think I have just enough resin for all of that. Well, I finally got it all assembled thanks to some hot water and mixing in a little bit of Tenacious. This worked a lot better than I was previously seeing, and for the most part, it went together seamlessly. Unfortunately, I did break one of the hinges here. That was the cover piece there that covers the head to the backpack area. And unfortunately, this resin just isn't perfect. It's close. I mean, it's very, very close. If the durability of this was just a little bit higher than it is, I think this would be fantastic. I'm still not seeing any chalkiness in any of the joints when I rub them back and forth multiple times, which again was the main factor for this resin compared to just running with standard resin that you might find and work with. You're gonna end up with lots of little chalky parts, just like you might have had on your old Nintendo 64 controllers. But I love that on this exosuit, you can lift up the top skull to reveal the face of the Space Marine. I also want to take a moment to say thank you to today's video sponsor, which is none other than Elgu, the makers of the Elgu Mars 3, as well as the Elgu Saturn S, which I printed all the parts in today for this particular project. I also used Elgoo's Wash and Cure Station, which is fantastic for cleaning off all of your resin 3D prints and curing them all in one unit. And as you know, I'm a huge fan of the Elgoo Neptune 2 series of FDM 3D printers and own a ton of them for my 3D print farm. If you're interested in more information about any of Elgoo's products that I've shown off in today's video, you'll find links to those down below. And again, a huge thank you to Elgoo for continuing to support me making crazy videos like this one here. Now, this print from TeccoToys turned out pretty good, but what happened to the articulating print from soozafone? Well, I'm happy to say this thing came together so well using the hot water technique. Unfortunately, I didn't capture the assembly process on video. It took me probably 30 to 40 minutes to get this thing fully assembled. I did have to sand down some areas to get them to properly join together, and I had two joints that broke and I ended up resin welding them back together. But this articulates in, like, it's just crazy. It's a crazy how many articulation points there are and how stylistic you can make this particular figure. Plus, there's an actual stand that it comes with, so you can do all sorts of different crazy action poses with this particular figure. And best of all, it's free to download over on Prusa Printers, and I would highly recommend printing this either in resin or on an FDM 3D printer. And again, the assembly on this one was a little bit easier than the TeccoToy print. However, it was a lot more complex in terms of all the different parts and getting it actually put together, but all the joints were a little bit easier to pop together other than the two that I had to resin weld together. Is this the perfect resin for 3D printable action figures? No, but it's really close, and adding in a little bit of the Tenacious really helped with the assembly process and parts not breaking. But overall, if the durability was just a little bit stronger on the resin, this would work so much better. And unfortunately, the price of this is very expensive at $75 a bottle, and I ended up going through almost two bottles for this project and have lots of wasted pieces here that I just am not gonna be able to use. But the fact that these actually produce prints that when rubbed together do not provide any chalkiness is really incredible to see, and I honestly have not been able to see that with any other resin that I've ever worked with. If you're interested in more information about any of the prints that I've shown off here from TeccoToys or this articulating figure from soozafone over on Prusa Printers, I'll have links to those down below, along with links to the Mecha resin that you can find over on Amazon. But if you have resin recommendations that I should check out for 3D printable action figures that you think is a great fit, let me know down below, because I'm currently hunting for a much bigger project that's in the works. Fingers crossed will be happening here soon. But thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye now. I also want to say a thank you to all of my Patreon supporters for your continued support. If you're interested in my resin 3D printer settings, including support settings, you can find those in my Patreon, as well as some behind the scenes look at my upcoming studio build.